Yeah,
thanks for the thanks for the evidence. You defrying our brand.
I think some of these folk songs sort of encapsulate a feeling at very important times in Irish history, which is sort of has been remembered both in poetry and in music. And I suppose singing these songs is important because it allows us to sort of remember the sacrifice that was made so that we could now have an actually self-run government, at least in most of Ireland. And I think that's important to remember because that's, you know, something that was really long fought for that we've just been blessed with because of the sacrifice of people who came before.
It was down the glen one Easter morn to a city fair o'ride. There armed lines of marching men in squadrons passed me by. No fife did hum nor battle drum did sound its red tattoo, but the Angelus bell or the Liffey swell rang out in the foggy dew. Right proudly high o'er Dublin town they hung out the flag of war. It was better to die neath an Irish sky than at Sulva or Sodel Bar. And from the plains of Royal Meath strong men came hurrying through, while Britannia's Huns with their long-range guns sailed in through the foggy June. It was England bade our wild geese go, that small nations might be free. But their lonely graves are by Sulva's waves, or the shore of the great North Sea. Had they died by Pierce's side, or fought with Carl Brua, their names we would keep where the Fenians sleep in the shroud of the foggy June. But the bravest fell, and the solemn bell rang mournfully and clear. For those who died that Eastern tide, the springtime of the year. The world did gaze in deep amaze at those fearless men, but few who bore the fight that freedom's light might shine through the foggy dew.
When ye fell in the foggy June.